Okay, this in the last few weeks in Pioneer, we have been working on the Ten Commandments. So we've learned the Ten Commandments, and now I'm going to teach you guys how to remember the Ten Commandments. So the first commandment is, everybody. What is the first commandment? One finger? One God, right. The next one is we put up two fingers, and we make an X, because it's no idols, yes. Then we put up three fingers, and we put them close to our mouth, because that symbolizes? Yes, don't misuse God's name. And number four, sort of put your hand by your head, and that is to? Worship and rest. We remember the Sabbath. And number five, honor your parents. This is a symbol for father and mother, so honor your parents. Now we have six fingers. You guys got to do it. So we kind of put the finger towards us, because this is like we're trying to hurt ourselves. But it is, do not murder. Okay, number seven, our seven fingers. Five hands, this is sort of like the children, and this is the mom and dad. So we cross our fingers like this, because mom and dad always stay together. So it is no, that's a big word, adultery. Okay, eight, we put these fingers out, and then try to grab it with our hand. So that means no stealing, yeah. And number nine, we put all nine fingers up close to our mouth, because it is do not lie. And number 10, sort of go like this with all your fingers. No, do not covet. Do not covet, like you're trying to grab other stuff that people have that you want. So we also learned a song about it, so we're going to sing our song.
Child, you keep the tackle.
much we love and care. We can't forget the fun cards and the goodies we receive on our special day. Especially those small, colorful candies and the messages printed on them. Do you know what I'm talking about? What are they? Conversational cards, right? I received this. God's conversational heart. What do you think? Isn't that cold? Yeah. God gave us conversational hearts. So I think maybe we should read a couple. You know, see how much God really, really moves us. Okay? Do I know you? Of course he knows us. This can't be right. Because in Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 5, God says he knew us before we were even in the womb. Before we even came out of the tummy. So this can't be right. This has to be a joke. Yeah. Really. I like you a little. Really? Let's see. Because throughout the Bible, God declared his love for us, his everlasting love. Am I right? That's big love. That's more than a little, right? Yeah, that's what I thought. I think this one's absolutely wrong, too. I think that's a wrong boss, don't you think? Oh, here we go again. Can I break your heart? Really? Here we go. Oh boy. This is completely wrong. I must have picked up the wrong box. I really sure did. Because God will never break our heart. In Psalm chapter 147, verses 3, it says he heals our broken heart. And he binds up our wounds. So I don't think God would ever break our heart. Do you really think so? I don't think so either. Oh, good. This is... Be mine. That's what we want here. Doesn't God ask us this very same question for each of us every day? So... God really, 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 really wants to know, will you be his? Will you be his? God didn't hear you.
Yes.
Oh. Dusty, do you really want to be his?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, you guys really need to wake up. Really. See it a little differently now. Because it's interesting how God can get our attention. It may be through words of song or nature, or even the heart candies. He's speaking to us, we just have to listen to him. There's something we can't shop for or have it delivered, and it's God's love for us. Now, before I say this ending prayer, God also teaches us to give to others. And my family wanted to get together when I started putting this conversational heart box together. They really were amazed. And they asked me, what can I do? So they decided they wanted to help. They got me some materials through the candy, through making the hearts of grandchildren. And this is Miss Liz helping me. This is my whole entire family helping me. wanted to say Happy Valentine's Day to you guys, okay? And before I say the message, before you go to Children's Church, I have a present from my whole entire family. It's back in the Children's Church, and we're the pioneer stuff. Okay, so you all know where that's at. Okay? May we bow our heads. Dear God, as we rise to meet you each new day, fill us with your Spirit so we can be guided with your love. Remind us that love is always near, because you are never far, and to help us to remember what you sacrificed for us, to show us how to love, and remind us to show us how to love others. Amen.